Hey everyone, welcome to another Abacus Thermal tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you a very simple thermal loading. So let's get right to it. Okay, we open the Abacus, we use the standard model, and as always, we create the part. The part must be 2D planner because we want to make it as simple as possible, and it's shell deformable. And this time, I'm going to simulate this in the metric unit, so I put the value of 0.4 meter for the whole domain, and I want to create a rectangle. This guy should be 0.03 and this one must be 0.2. It's in meter, and by pressing the scroll button and done, we have the model. So I want to have two materials connected together from this very center. So I'm going to go to the tools, and from partition and face, I use the shortest path between two points and click these two. Then create partition. Boom, I have two parts here. And we are done with the part. Now we can go to the property, and I want to create two material properties. The top one is stainless steel 304. So we need general density. As it is metric, it is 8000 kilogram per meter cube. And from mechanical elasticity elastic, we have the Young's modulus, which is 193 E9 0.29. And from mechanical expansion, we have the coefficient of thermal expansion, which is 17.2 E minus 6, and thermal conductivity is 16.2, and the last but not least specific heat, which is 500. Alright, this is the stainless steel 304. We hit OK. We need to create another material, which is ST52, a general steel, carbon steel. The density would be 7850, and mechanical elasticity elastic is a little higher, 210 E9, but the Poisson's ratio is the same, 0.29. mechanical expansion, the thermal expansion is 10.8 E minus 6, and thermal conductivity, the conductivity is higher, 56.9, and the last one, the specific heat, is a little lower, which is 423. This is the materials properties. Now we need to create sections. I create the top section, should be solid homogeneous. If you wonder why we have 2D shell and we have solid homogeneous, watch the video on top. I told the reason why. Okay, so I create the top, continue, and the material must be stainless steel 304. So I create another section, should be bottom, solid homogeneous, and it should be ST52. Okay, now it's time to assign the sections. The top one must be assigned to the stainless steel. I uncheck this one in order not to create too many sets, and I click done. This is top. It says the material is stainless steel 304. Okay, now I click on this one, click on done, and the bottom, which is ST52. Now it turned green, it means the sections are assigned. But if you want to check whether you have two different materials, you should click on this one, and by materials, you see you have different materials. You can change the colors if you want, but it doesn't matter right now. Okay, we're good to go to the assembly, which is pretty simple. I click on create instance, and as I have only one part, I rather it to be independent. Click on OK. I always translate the instance to the center of the coordinates, and by clicking on auto fit view, we have this on center. Okay, the assembly part is done. Now we go to the step, create step. The step must be coupled thermal displacement, and we continue. The time period must be 1 second, And from the incrementation, the increment size, which is the delta T, is 0.1. And the maximum allowable temperature change per increment must be 1. The higher this number is, the lower your accuracy of simulation would be. Okay, I accept this value and pass to the next one, which is the load. Here from the boundary condition, I want to create a couple of boundary conditions here. The first one must be the mechanical from the displacement and rotation type. I select this one by holding shift. I select the other one. Now click on done. I prevent these materials to translate in X and Y direction. So I click on done. Now the big question is how to apply the thermal load. It's not here. So let's go to the predefined field. And from initial step and other, we can use the temperature. Click on continue. We select both of them. And we can say the magnitude is 20. So it means at first, both of the beams are in 20 degree centigrade. Now we're going to apply the boundary condition here. So from create other temperature and in step one, I'm going to click on continue. We assume that this one still has 20 degrees centigrade and the top one is going to be as high as 100 degrees centigrade. Okay, now it means, for instance, the beam was built inside the company. Now it's going to be used in outside in hot temperature and the temperature gets as high as 100 degrees centigrade. Now it's going to affect the bottom one and we're going to see how it goes. Okay, now it's time to go to mesh. From here, we can set the part 0.002. and click OK. And I want to assign the mesh control. It must be quad and structured. I click OK. And now we must mesh the part. So I click on this one and say yes. We have a mesh here. Last but not least, we have to assign the element type. I select on this one. OK. Now it should be coupled temperature displacement. And I click OK. Now it's time to create the job. I'd like to rename it to thermal load. Continue. OK. Now I want to submit the job and see how it goes. OK, the job is completed. Now we want to go and see the results. So if I plot the contour deform shape, I can see it like this, or from option comment, I would like to put it on feature edges to see that better. As you see, by having a temperature differences between 20 degrees centigrade and 100 degrees centigrade, we can have like 288 megapascal. Or if you want to see the displacement, you can see the displacement, which is the highest at this part, but the stress is the highest right over here. You can also see the animation here if you put it somewhere around here and click on animate time history. You can see how it changes with respect to the time. You can also see multiple plot states. For instance, if you put it on this one and this one, you can see how much it displays. It's a cool option to see. That's it. Thanks for watching. If you need the files, just let me know in the comments. And if you want to learn additive manufacturing simulation, click on the video on the screen before it ends. And don't forget to subscribe to see more. See you in the next one.